Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Sarthak Sardana. I'm 30 years old. I'm from New Delhi. To start my talk, I'm going to say sometimes it's a half-hearted effort which changes your career, changes your interest in different subjects. And sometimes people give their best just to be discouraged by the environment. And sometimes you get such a platform to talk about the success. Today, I'm going to take you to a journey of my DJing career, how from being a chartered accountant, I changed to become a music producer and a DJ now. A lot of people ask me, why is my name Sartek? So my real name is Sarthak Sardana. So what the kind of music I make is international dance music. So when I started making music, I used to be in touch with a lot of international DJs, producers. So they were never used to be able to pronounce my name. Sometimes it would be Sarthak, sometimes Sarthok. So I thought, okay, so to do anything to make a brand, you should have a very a generic name, which it's easily spoken by people in different countries also. That's why I came up with the name Sartek. The story goes way back in 2007 when I cleared my first ever CA exam, the entrance exam. And luckily, somehow coming from a CA family, the first attempt I gave, I cleared. So everybody was very happy in the family. And my father gave me some money. Okay, take 1,000 rupees, go to a bar, chill, have a few beers. There, while having beers, I saw a very cool poster of an international DJ playing just next to my town. I told my friend, hey man, let's go, let's see this show. Looks very exciting. I still remember in 2007, I reached the venue. There was this international DJ making people go mad. They were all jumping, dancing, and the DJ had the same height as mine. I'm like, wow. People are saying, hey man, we love you, what a DJ. I was completely blown away. I'm like, okay, this is a new exposure to music. People love, they're rock stars, and I'm doing CA, studying 9 to 5, doing what? Being a fanboy, went back home, searched the DJ up and down, started listening to more music. I downloaded 100 tracks that day, I still remember. So that's the first time my exposure to dance music, to being a DJ, was exactly mesmerizing, because that time, right before that, I was just studying, doing my tuitions, meeting different teachers, doing accounts and economics, and then suddenly I listened to music and meet rock stars. So this was the first day in my studio. This was in 2009, when 2 years after giving my second level examination, and this was 2018, this was playing to about 5,000 people in Ahmedabad. So after listening to all different kinds of music so EDM has a lot of kind of music, trance, techno, big room. So basically it's the same kind of music, but different kind of styles. So I was thinking, okay, this is what I really love. This is something I'm going to make a career in. 2 years of struggle, listening, traveling, trying to convince my parents who have no idea what DJing is. My father being angry at me every day. Tu beta kya karega? Tu DJ banega? Tu samajh nahi aati kya karna chahta hai? I thought of joining an academy in New Delhi. From my CA tuition fees, I used to save some money, joined an academy. And the first day of the academy, when I entered, I had no idea what music is. What is a keyboard? What is a guitar? What are drums like? I entered the first lesson, the teacher mesmerized. Okay, you know what music is. Your idea of music is quite cool, but you're still very raw. So you have to keep learning for 3-4 more years and try to know the basics of sounds and how music works. It took me 4 years to understand the basics. In 2013, I made a track which I sent it to different labels and different artists all over the world. Suddenly, one fine morning, I still remember in 2013, October, I got an email from a very big DJ called Tiesto saying, hey Sartek, I love your music and I want to sign you. I was again mesmerized. Okay, so now this DJing is working for me. Music producer, a big guy like Tiesto wants to work with me. That's what made me realize, okay, I might be good at it, but I'm not really sure if this is exactly the career for me in my future. Once that track went online, people started listening to it. It became viral on YouTube. I started getting shows. So after getting shows, in the same year of 2013, I was playing alongside all the biggest artists. So these guys are like the big names in the DJing industry. That's Chucky, that's Snake, that's Martin Garrix, that's Kashmir. So in 2014, this was after the first track, the kind of support I was getting. I was feeling very lucky because thanks to all the international festivals, thanks to these guys coming down who were supporting my music, and I was playing with them. Then this is one of the biggest gigs which actually changed my life. This guy is called Hardwell. He was playing in DB Patil Stadium, and I was just playing before him. So this picture is a picture where I went up to him trying to stalk him and told him, hey man, I'm Sartek. He's like, oh, you're from India, you're from Delhi. So that's the exact moment. And the day after that, I was the first Indian DJ to be followed by him. So that's the one picture screenshot I have. So when I started my talk, I spoke about a DJ who I met in 2007, who blew my life away. So this guy was Armin Van Buuren. This is the picture on that day, clearing my first year exam. And this is the time I played with him in 2018 in Goa. So now I knew, okay, this music is something which I love. I'm good at it because I'm playing with all the big names. This is something which I can make my career in. But does it actually pay well? Will it be able to, I will be able to convince my father that I'll pay my own rent, pay my own electricity bills? My father, who was a complete orthodox person, he never believed that DJing could be a career, music is something you could do. Coming from a family full of CAs, he used to call me a bandwala at home. So when I used to come, he was like, oh, bandwala aa gaya. So I took my father for a gig to Goa. That was the first time he saw people running after me to click pictures. After that day, my name from bandwala became a rock star at home. So after that, in 2015, I got a first ever international show in Bangkok. So my father, thinking that this guy has gone out of hand now, he has nothing else to do, just to play music, and now he's going to Bangkok just for fun, there's no show, so he came along with me. Unfortunately, he passed away a day before my first ever international show in Bangkok, and that's the time I realized, okay, now this music is not about a pocket, it's not about pocket money, it's about the self-sustenance, and it's about saving the present income and trying to become something in life. That's the time I realized that music is something which I have to excel at, and then I have to make a career out of it. So this is the Venn diagram which I made. So life is not as easy as this Venn diagram. Sometimes these circles won't align. But with the amount of information, the kind of support, and with the right guidance, right confidence, the only person who can stop from becoming you is you. Thank you.